Hey, good morning. Let me test and see for the last time if it works. If it doesn't work, then it means that I'm on some form, but see if I can look. I'm on some form, I'm a veteran line also. Okay, I'm waiting for your response. You're going to talk about free SHS. Good. It looks like it's working. Kweku, can you hear me, Kweku? If you can hear me, I think it's working now. Okay. Good morning, everybody. I had a very good week. In fact, I had fun. You know, I have my grill in my house. So every small thing, oh, it's a party. And this weekend, is a great week for Ghana because His Excellency the President and the NPP party administration introduced this. And you see, when I saw this, what it reminded me of is what Nanado said at so many rallies. Nanado does not do promise and fail. You see, if you live in a country where women give birth in a hospital, two women, after delivering, they sleep on one bed. Those are the fortunate ones. Though. Some sleep on the floor to give birth. The people who pay tax, the people who have worked, the people who work 24 hours and they pay tax, they sleep on the ground to give birth. And the people who don't pay anything because they went into an election and won, they can spend $14 million building one house for a vice president alone to go and stay inside. You know, the leaders are not intelligent, they are not sensible. In fact, they are useless people. You don't even have to find different way. When you live in a country like Ghana, you say you can spend $13 million. Nanado, as president of Ghana, says he's introducing free SHS so that everybody must go to school, secondary school, for free. Now, Nanado knew that most people will come and do that, talk plenty. So he made it very simple. Nanado is not waiting for NPP communicators to come and say the thing, and so then people go and read meanings. Now, this is what Nanado said. He said that, I'm going to read, he said that, he explained that by free SHS, there will be no admission fees, no library fees, no science center fees, no computer lab fees, no examination fees, and no utility fees. That is what Nanado means by free SHS. Spelling out the details of the policy so that no one in Ghana is left in any doubt, especially those people who are only wishing that Nana's government won't go well. Those people who will be left in doubt. This is what Nanado said. President Akufo-Addo added that in addition to tuition, which is already free, there will be free textbooks, free boarding, and free meals. And the students will get a meal at school for free. Just carry your chobos and go to school. If you're a day student, when you're going to school, go with your bowl, you will eat in the afternoon. Maybe they will even give you a bowl in the school. What else? You see, when a government is doing things like this, so that the school fees money that the parents are paying, go and buy this year beer school, you can use that money to drink beer. And now even those who manufacture beer, they don't even get money. Because you have to put all your money in school fees. The school has reopened. Everybody. Nanado has made it very simple. Free means free. If you are in a country and you have 13 million, 14 million to build a vice president's mansion, and you can't give kids in secondary school free education, where free means free, you are a very useless country. We are 60. Now, I am very happy. Nanado, the money that you are putting in Ghana at 60, you have to increase it. If any government can give us these things, then you say we are going to celebrate Ghana at 60. What have you achieved at 60 years? Children are going to school, to secondary school for free. Somebody said that it is the quality. Master, education is better than literacy. Any form of education is better than being an illiterate. So whether the quality or whatever, any form of education is better than being an illiterate. Not to talk of formal education. So that everybody, you wake up, you go to school. If you are in a country and you can have health care Government is giving you health care. So you don't have to be sick and have money in your pocket before you can get health care. If you are sick and you don't have money in your pocket and you have to die because you don't have sika, how are you living? If any government can give you health care and give you free education, Master, you can chop Ghana at 60 with any amount of money you want. Which one is anybody's problem? What do we want? What do you want? People can go to hospital for free. They can go to secondary school for free. And the system is working. Even Ghana 60 is small. Christmas, we have to do fireworks because we are celebrating what we are putting into the country. But if people are there, you are not getting anything. The country is not working. So you are going to use money to chop. And apart from that, what even the government is doing now is that, apart from restoring teacher training allowances, teachers are going to also get bungalow. $13 million can build bungalows for plenty teachers in Ghana. So Nanado has sat down and noticed that. If one vice president can get $13 million house to live inside, that we can give teachers in Ghana to bungalows. Yeah, yeah, campaign in Amoye Dede. This we are doing what will make people in the country happy. People that will give some things that will give life to people. If you go and build second interchange and nobody has a car to go there and fuel is expensive and all of that, what are we talking about? Now, national health insurance is going to work. Now, free education in September. Carry your troubles and go to school. The only issue I have is that I'm asking myself, if me I live in, say, Aguna Swedru, they say free SHS. Swed school is there. I have kids who are in the house and they are chopping plenty. As if I go and put them in the school, they will eat in the school. They will learn. Why should they stay in the house? Everybody will just carry their kids. Nobody will be a student. Nobody wants to be in the boarding house. Because you go to boarding, you eat 3 times a day. You will learn. So I'm sure that the education ministry will look at these things and see how are we going to go about it. Who goes to the day? But if you ask me, you have to learn hard and pass at a certain level to be admitted into the boarding house. It's true, but you have to learn and pass so that even that one will encourage the children to learn. So before you are admitted into the boarding house, you, the parents in the house, tell your children, say, when you are there, I won't call boarding. Say, when you are there, you can't just sit in the house and be misbehaving and fooling and playing around. Then because you come from the town or you go, we have to add it. You have to learn hard to get a certain mark to be admitted in the boarding house so that you encourage the children to learn. Apart from that I think that they should look at it and look at what we can do about. I think that when government is doing this, look, I've said this over and over and over. Most of you have not thought of it. In the history of this country, so many of us paid money to become Ghanaians. We paid. If your mother goes to hospital to give birth to you, she doesn't have money, they will seize her in the hospital. She has to work and until somebody comes to pay for her. Sometimes you have to stay in the hospital and work to offset your bills. Then President Kufuor came and said, no, you can't pay money to be Ghanaian. So they brought free maternal care, free delivery for women. If I don't want to play ball for Ghana, I say Ghana made you. His mother paid money for him to become Ghanaian. His mother paid money for him to go to secondary school. The day Ayo's parents paid for him to be even just to be born. They paid for him to go to school. Nobody gave him baby food. So if he doesn't want to play football for Ghana, what is your problem? Now that Nanadu is going back to free maternal. When your mother gets pregnant, you take care of her. When she's going to born, it's free. The baby will get education for free. Then you can stand on a football field and wear Ghana jersey and be proud to play for Ghana because the country has made you. The country has done so many things for you. That is it. In England, Rooney and them, they are proud to give something back to their country. In Ghana, your mother will sell her clothes to buy you a football boot. You say, Sule Muntari must come and play ball by force. It is now that Nanadu is introducing the things that will make people patriotic, things that will make people feel that they owe this country. They have to do something for the country. That's the thing that we are looking for. The people who are making noise, they say Nanado has gone imported chocolate and they have put some chocolate choice. Those people there, they have put some chocolate pictures on social media and they are making noise. That chocolate, me, I ate some at inauguration. It was somebody, I don't know, so Nanado Winnie, you know, she was happy and she made her own chocolate. It is not for Ghana 60. It's that chocolate. It's not Nanado who went and imported it. Even Nanado, it was the person who went and dashed him one to taste and see if it's nice. Nanado and the Ghana 6, they have not imported any chocolate. We are running this country. This country must be in such a way that the teacher's daughter goes to school free. The teacher's son goes to school free. The teacher's son gets food. The daughter gets food. The teacher has a place to sleep. There's too much money in this country. When we talk, we say there is no money. There is no money. Where did the 30 million come? So look at all the money that we spent in this country on unnecessary things. There's so much money in this country. And Nanado is going to use that money well. And Nanado, see, I say when you are giving people free health care, free education, oh, you can chop Ghana 60 because we have achieved plenty. Enjoy it. And even that, Nanado did not say we are going into government account and go and take money and use it to chop Ghana 60. No. Say private sector. And there are so many people, I'm telling you today, there are so many people in private sector who want to do something for Ghana 60. They just want to bring money. They want to support. There are so many people who want to help private. Look, it will reach a time, eh? Even sponsorship for this Ghana 60, people won't get slots. You want to do something, but somebody has taken it. You have to even beg to help Ghana. That's the kind of leadership you are looking for. People want to be part. People want to put money inside. But I'm telling you that the kind of person that Nana is, the government that Nana has brought, that money, even though it is sponsorship money, it is not going into unnecessary things. It is going into things that will benefit the people of this country. So when you are sitting anywhere, somebody say, oh, the 20 million is too much. That 20 million there is just too much money. Ask the person that, what is the money going to be used for? If you are spending 20 million on Ghana at 60, and the 20 million is going to be used to build some of the schools that Nanado said is going to continue to build for people to go free, what is anybody's problem? If Nanado and his government go on like this, even NDC, they say they are social democrats. Social democrat means that they care about people. Who, they care about people. They care about themselves. If Nanado and his government go on like this, NPP will be in power for a very long time. I was saying the Tom. People must enjoy being Ghanaians. People must get education. Hey, if Nanado and his government will continue like this, hey, see, any Ghana 60, hey, chop. Enjoy it. Because when Ghana was 60 years, we made secondary education free. Where free means free. In the next few years, you know how many people we would have educated in this country? Way back 10 years ago, spent millions of dollars on Ghana at 50. They say, yes, it was NPP that was in power. And then NPP went to the, they went to the bench. They sat down, they have learned, and then we come back 10 years, fast forward. We are spending 4.5 sponsorship money on things that will benefit the country. We are moving forward. We are moving forward as a country. For the first 100 days in office, Nana Akufo-Addo says that everything is free. When Nana had to get to the place where he made the announcement at 10 o'clock, he got there a second late. 01:01. Be like Nana. Be on time. Ghana is moving forward. We are changing everything in this country. Everything in this country is changing. Positive change. You will never regret voting for Nanado. Free education. NDC Nibe Kubi. MPP Nibe Kubi. CPP Nibe Kubi. Free means free. When you are going, they won't take your party card and ask you which party you belong to. Every child in Ghana is going to get some level of education. Then now they are going about making noise. They say that they spent 250,000 on logo and what. NDC for now, we have propaganda no? And throw no mukra. No? Don't listen to those things. We are focused. Nanado is running this country. Nanado has not imported any chocolate. Nanado, the kind of person he is, where he comes from, that is where Tete Kwashi comes from, that area. You go and import chocolate from where? Nanado has not imported any chocolate for Ghana City. Don't mind them, forget them. Then those people, the people that are following them are the 300. And we are here. The truth will tell you. Don't mind those people. Nanado has not imported any chocolate. In Ghana right now, even if you are living abroad, you can bring your children home to go to school. And it's not that kind of free feeding in school that give you a soup, like fish and stew. And this is free food. When you watch the soup, it's like a fish pond. You see the fish standing inside water like this. Tomato, grain, epi and a papa. Good food. whether it is quality education or it is education, it is better for anybody to, the kind of education we are getting today now, it is going to be free. You are going to add free textbooks. Technical and vocational institutions are included. God bless Nanado. If you don't like this one, what else do you want? Who didn't vote for Nana? Now change your mind. If we just want people who can run this country and make the country better for all of us. If you can't, you are not going to build big, big hospitals so that we will spend plenty money on contract and take some and put it in our pocket. Me, I voted for Nana. I campaigned for Nana. Ever since I have not even gone to Nana. Nana has not given me anything. Nana, if he has to give me money, he said we should go to private sector. He doesn't have any money for anybody. Should go to private sector. So me, I'm going about, I'm looking for my own business. So long as the economy is good and it supports our business and we are doing well, we are not looking for government money for anything. If me, I go and take government money, all the millions of people who voted for Nana, what would they get? Yenchen pepe. Everybody do your business and get your money. God bless Nanado. If you continue like this, by 1 year time, I'm saying this one, all the media people, see the people who are watching, almost 1K people. Hey, Charlie, the people they watch my video past Fox News. So. See, by 1 year time, I'm telling you this, you can use it for your news headline. By next year, by this time, Nanado have achieved more than what the NDC did in 8 years. I repeat, by a year today, Nanado would have achieved more than what NDC achieved in 8 years. NCC Bridge, we're doing what will benefit you, your life. So your children can go to school free, so that you can use the money to buy club. You save some, use some to drink beer. Nipa so yadien, mumia num beer kakrawate. And this is a beer crying men, adain. By kind courtesy of Nana, now people can drink beer. Hey, you save some of the money, you use some to buy brunya and things for your children, you can buy a cocoa, because government is taking plenty of you. You can drink beer. Nanado's government, yebenum beer. I love you. Enjoy the week. Those who come to my page and come and talk plenty. This is my page. It's like Joy FM, my joy online. Peace FM online. This is Kwame Plus online. I come here to tell you the news according to me. If you don't like, block me. Me, my TV crowd, the way Mark Zuckerberg did it, if you don't like, you can block. Me, I don't like some TV. When I tell my DSTV, the people are on. They are making noise. I don't like them. Man, you can block me. It's so simple. God bless Nana. Me call the daddy.